How's it going, internets? I hope you're having a lovely day. It's that time again. It's time to get into some animation. It's time to get those creative juices flowing. Time to get that imagination running wild. And it's time to get inspired. And today's inspiration comes from Dave Stevens. If you're not familiar with his work, check right over here. He is the creative mind behind The Rocketeer. If you've never watched The Rocketeer, if you've never read The Rocketeer comics, do yourself a favor and go do that right now because it's phenomenal stuff. As you can see, his artwork is just top-notch. One of my favorites in probably the last 20 years of penciling and inking. Just really great. I love his forms. His anatomy is always top-notch. Great posing, great layout, great composition. And really creative characters as well. And definitely takes some character design and creation to a new level that I just adore. I love the little bulldog restaurant that he has there. Just a phenomenal creator. And like I said, if you're not familiar with his stuff, he has done other work as well, but my favorite personally is just the Rocketeer stuff. It really, really resonates with me. I loved it when I was a kid, and I still do to this day. But this guy's great. And this Alien Worlds comic, really great, kind of a gesture type feel with the alien head. So creative. But yeah, look at that. I mean, that pencil work is just phenomenal. Great layout, great posing. Just great. But anyways, I wanted to share a little quote that I found of his with you guys today. That was, well, I do expect a lot of myself. I'm a harsh critic because I know what I'm capable of, and I have hit those occasional peaks amongst the valleys, but the peaks are so few. Things like genuine flashes of virtuoso brush inking, like I've never executed before or since. I can count on one hand the number of jobs where I've been able to hit that mark. Same with penciling. Sometimes it just flows, but more often than not, it's pure physical and spiritual torment just to get something decent on paper. I often get very discouraged with the whole creative process. And you might not think that that's inspiring, but to me that's totally, totally inspiring. Because of someone who I look up to who's so phenomenal in their work, thinks so similar to how I do, where I'm super hypercritical of my own work, and you know, there's always those days where you look at it and you just are like, you know, is this even worth it? Am I even going anywhere with this? And then there's other days where you're like, wow, you know what, that came out of me. And I think the goal of studying and pushing yourself is so that those peaks and those valleys aren't as vast of a difference, so you don't have like a horrible drawing next to a phenomenal drawing, but you can kind of bring it down to maybe not as solid of a drawing and a pretty solid drawing, and you get a little more consistency in those peaks and valley gaps. But like I said, to me it's always motivational. One of my favorite things that I think about quite often is Milt Call has a quote of saying, "I struggle like hell to make a drawing look good." And if someone who's so mastered their craft still has days like that, or still has feelings like that, then I think, you know, for those of us who are still learning, still on that journey, haven't quite hit that master level yet, it's motivating to think that even people who are at the top of their game still have those days. So that being said, let's go ahead and get into our animation for today. And today's rig is the Scorpio Ship rig. It is a free rig you can grab over at Creative Crash. Kind of a different style, almost like a Transformer kind of a rig. So I'm not quite sure how I'm going to approach this one yet, but I think that'll be fun to play around with. And if you're not familiar with what we'll be doing for the rest of the video, we give ourselves 48 frames. It's like 2 seconds of animation. And I go off and I find a different rig that I've never used before, something that's a free resource that you guys can try out. And we see where we go from there, a little bit of kind of hang out with me while I animate, a little bit of instruction, a little bit of just fun, and hope that you guys feel like you're not alone in your art day. You do have a buddy out there going through the journey with you. And overall, I hope the end goal is that you guys get inspired and motivated to go off and create your own stuff. And if you do, definitely share it back so I can see all the wonderful stuff you're creating. And that being said, let's go ahead and dive right in here. Turn the grid off, and let's create a polygon primitives cube here. And bring that down, make sure we just have the curves this yet, so we're just going to do quick save. And remember, when you're working to save multiple versions and to save often, and we are using Autodesk Maya 2014. And again, a link to more stuff about Dave Stevens, a link to this rig, and for more information about Maya, you can always check out the description down below if you guys are interested in that. And let's go ahead and just call this Scorpio. And, okay. So I was thinking it's kind of a mix of like a crawl and a hover. Let's see if we can do something like that. So let's go ahead and raise that up. One of them. There's one more you can still do. There we go, this one. Because then the feet still stay planted. Let's go ahead and grab all of the feet here. So I'm gonna pull it inward. Let's try and have a good balance there though. It's actually not too bad. And then let's splay them a little bit, so we'll bring the front and the back feet in a little bit, and have those middle ones sticking out a little bit more. Just trying to create a more interesting pose with this rig. And let's go ahead and see if we can drop those down, kind of focus them forward a little bit more. So definitely a different style of rig here. And let's go ahead and get into this tail here. Let's bring that down. Look on one, two, break it up into groups of four. So we'll have a middle group and top group. One, two, three. Okay. All right, that's a fairly interesting pose. You could probably do a little bit more. Up on that one, and a little more down there. Just get a little better arc throughout there. All right, what's this gonna? Repel them for now. Okay, look, that's an okay pose to start off with. Let's grab everything, set our frame range from 0 to 48, and let's overfile one more time. Grab everything, make sure we just have our curves, nerve surfaces, and polygons selected, and we'll set our first key. And let's see. Let's bring those back. Let's bring those forward. Let's go. comes to like a 20, oh, 30, 40, and back again. So let's see that. Same template on the other middle foot. Just doing something different with that foot on the other one. Thank you. things just in case. Raise it up again. Put it down. Raise it up again. Bring it down. So let's see here. Thank you. again, this is just kind of the foundation stuff, and then we'll get into a bunch of the accessories and stuff that are in this rig, but we want to build it up first. So these are on the same. it's always good to kind of get one side closer to polish, so when you do the other side, you have a good template for how you want to approach it. You want to add a little bit of this here. I'll trick it down a little bit. Another good thing, too, of having one side versus the other is you can kind of compare if you like it a little more over the top or a little more. Still do that. Key selected. Okay. Let's go and look at that. Do the opposite here. Missiles team. We'll probably put those back on fives here. Down on 10. Up on 5. Down on 10. 5. Down on 10. Just so we get that bit of drag and breakup of the movement between the missile holders and the missiles themselves and the body. Base of the Scorpio ship here. There we go. Now we got a little bit of drag there. And let's maybe minimize it a little bit more. So we don't get a lot of that, but it'll add to that feel of weight and everything throughout there. Actually accentuate the outer ones a little bit more so they'll drag down a little bit more. Okay. Let's see that. That's pretty good so far. Let's go and see that. And let's look at this wheel here. Down. Just trying to get different timing on everything so that everything doesn't hit all at the same time. Dirt. That makes sense. Just to mix it up a little bit more. Timing's one of the fun things that you can do to play around with, along with posing, to get extra little bit of flair. Okay, way too much, obviously. assistant. We've got a little bit of a slowdown in there right now. So let's see that now. Okay. And I think we're going to do maybe like a strike on the tail. Just to, again, mix up the timing a little bit more. I'm going to pull back here. And then we'll pull in here. It's good too. So it does overshoot a little bit. Let's see. It's going too fast. Let's give it a few more rooms to get in there. Let's see. Now I'll hold this a little bit longer. needs to be shorter, it needs to strike harder. Thank you. Let us settle on that foot here. Let's go and look at that now. Help sell the contact on that foot a little better. Okay, well, let's go and look at this guy. We'll do a similar thing. Again, let's look at the other side here. Again, rotate it forward. Rotate it forward. Rotate it forward. And bring it back. Okay, and we do it on the arm. Let's do some drag on this back foot as well. That way every foot works a little bit differently, front to back. I'll drag that back. Right. It's kind of a funky one, but I think it turned out alright. And let's go ahead and take a look back at where we started. We were looking at Dave Stevens today and his phenomenal work. And he says, well, I do expect a lot of myself. I'm a harsh critic because I know what I'm capable of. I have hit those occasional peaks amongst the valleys, but the peaks are so few. Things like genuine flashes of virtuoso brush, inking like I've never executed before or since. I can count on one hand the number of jobs where I've been able to hit that mark. The same with penciling. Sometimes it just flows, but more often than not, it's pure physical and spiritual torment just to get something decent on paper. I often get very discouraged with the whole creative process. And I think that's really inspirational to me because it means that someone who's already a phenomenal creator who does such amazing work, if they struggle and have their up days and their down days, that, you know, there's hope for the rest of us. And it's all about trying to get the peaks and the valleys, the gap between those times where you have your successes and you have your failures, to get that a little bit more pushed towards the success than the failure. So that being said, thanks again for watching, everybody. Thanks for liking and subscribing. I hope you guys are enjoying these videos and this series. We're still working through a bunch of new stuff, trying to rearrange the studio so I get a little bit better quality video and audio for you guys. And don't forget, if you do end up using this rig, to share back so I can see all the wonderful stuff you guys are coming up with. And same goes for anything you guys are creating. I just love to see the stuff you guys come up with. That being said, you guys are awesome. I love you lots, and we'll see you for some more animation tomorrow.